Everyone, I hope everyone is safe and doing good. Welcome back to my channel Record Rate with Mathematics. So this video is a continuation of one of my previous videos, that is binomial theorem. So in my previous videos I have clearly explained the concepts that you need to know in order to understand binomial theorem, and also we have seen using those concepts to how to expand binomial expansion using binomial theorem. So today's video is the continuation from where we've left in my previous video on binomial theorem. In today's video, we will see a few more concepts on binomial theorem. And if you haven't watched my previous videos yet, I will link it up here for you to watch so that you will understand the sequence of the videos. So without wasting any more time, now let's jump right into the video. So what is binomial theorem? If A and B are real numbers and n is a positive integer, then a plus b whole power of n can be written as nc0 a power of n b power of 0 plus nc1 a power of n minus 1 b power of 1 plus nc2 a power of n minus 2 b square and so on, plus ncr a power of n minus r b power of r plus and so on, plus ncn a power of 0 and b power of n. So this is binomial theorem that you know. I've told you a few observations related to algebraic expansions, if you remember. What were those? For example, a plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So in my first video, I've told you a few observations that you need to know on algebraic expansions. All those observations are applicable to binomial theorem as well. That is, number of terms in a binomial expansion is 1 greater than the power. In here, n is 2 for a plus b whole square and number of terms are 3. So therefore, for this also, for a plus b whole power of n, the number of terms in the expansion of a plus b whole power of n is n plus 1. Now, what is the next observation that we've seen? We've seen that powers, if you add all the powers of each term, then it should result in n. See here, 2, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2. Here also, if you add n and 0, or if you add n minus 1, 1, if you add n minus 2, 2, if you add those two, the powers of each term should result in n. And that is the same? Yes. Now, what is the third observation that I have told you? Third observation is all these coefficients, nc0, nc1, nc2 and so on, ncr, ncn, all these coefficients are represented on Pascal's triangle. Binomial theorem came after Pascal's triangle. The coefficients on Pascal's triangle, such as this, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. All these coefficients are nothing but in the form of LCR. So these coefficients are represented on Pascal's triangle, right? And if you see here, these coefficients are equidistant from one another. That is, if you write another row here, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Okay, so that means if you, these two coefficients, values are equal to these two values. That is, if 1, 4, 6, 4, 1 are, is, it is the fifth row of Pascal's triangle, then 4C2, 4C3, 4C4. If you observe, 4C0's value is equal to 4C4's value, 4C1's value is equal to 4C3's value, then 4C2 is standalone, it's the middle term. But if you see, they are equidistant from one another, right? The coefficients that are there towards both the corners are equal. The values of the coefficients of 4C0 and 4C4 in this place is equal. The value of coefficients of 4 and 4 is equal. 4C1 is 4C3. And this is nothing but NCR is equal to NCN minus R. I will tell you more about binomial coefficients in a bit. But this is one of the rules that you need to know. Okay, and the last observation is, if you see here, one of the terms in this expansion is A and the other term is B. So the power of the term, the power of the variable A is reducing when you go from left to right, and the power of the variable B is increasing. So here n, n minus 1, n minus 2 and so on, 0, and the power of variable B is what? 0, 1, 2 and so on, n. So the power of the variable A is reducing and power of the variable B is increasing. So all these we have seen in algebraic expansions. I have shown you these observations over there, and these are applicable to this as well. Okay, so this is the binomial theorem. We have seen that this is A plus B. Now let's try to see what happens if we take A minus B whole power of n. How do we expand this? What you need to do is, in place of B, put minus B in this expansion. That's it. So NC0 A power of n minus B whole power of 0 plus NC1 A power of n minus 1 and minus B whole power of 1 plus NC2 A power of n minus 2 and minus B whole square and so on plus, here we don't know the value of R. So what I will do is, for now I'll put this minus B whole power of R plus same thing, we don't know the value of n. So for now I'll put this. Okay, after doing this, what you can do is just take the minus symbol out. Here 1 to the power of 0, minus B whole power of 0 is 1, it's positive. Here minus to the power of odd, so it will be minus here b plus nc2 into a power of minus 2 into b square, because squaring on minus is positive, and so on plus, here we don't know the value of r, so what we'll do is we'll take minus 1 whole to the power of r. This minus 1, this r can be positive or negative, and depending on that the sign will change. So we'll get ncr a power of n minus r b to the power of r plus and so on plus nc, and again we don't know the value of n here, so we take minus outside, a to the power of 0 and b to the power of n. Okay, so take this as equation 1 and this is equation 2. So this is how we write the expansion of a minus b, that is, in this place it can be anything. If it's plus, we follow the general expansion. If it's minus, we take alternate the symbols of minus according to the value of the power. Now I've named this as 1 and 2. I want to see what happens if you add these two. That is, a plus b whole power of n plus a minus b whole power of n. What happens in this case? You know for a fact that a plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. And a minus b whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. And now what happens if you add these two? That is, what happens when a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square are added together? We'll get what? 2 into a square plus b square. And what happens if you subtract these two? A plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square. We get 4ab. Right. So, the result, this result varies depending upon the power. So if it's cube, the result may differ. If it's 4, the result may differ, etc. But this is a general result that we've been using so far in any algebraic expansions or expressions that we solve. So how did we get to this result? We just added, we cancelled this, and we arrived at this result, right? The same thing is applicable to this also. Here, what we are saying is n is 2 here. So when you take n as 2, these are the results. When you take n as 3, the result might be different. When you take n as 4, the result might be different. But the procedure remains the same. So here we have added these two and we have cancelled this in order to get this. And if you want to subtract, we'll cancel these and we'll get 4ab. Right. Here what we need to do is, we need to cancel appropriate terms and we'll now arrive at the result. And that varies from n to n, the values of n. So, a plus b whole power of n plus a minus b whole power of n can be written as, first let's take the first term, we are adding it, right? So, this is the first term, this is the first term. So, it will be 2, a power of n, b power of 0 is 1 only. So, nc0 a power of n, right? Next, we are adding these two, right? So, you compare this with this. Here, we have minus and here we have plus. So we are adding. So don't you think these two will get cancelled? Yes, because these two are same terms. Then These two will get cancelled. Then again, compare this with this. These two will add plus 2nc to a power of n minus 2b square. Same way, odd terms will get cancelled. Even terms will get added. I mean, even powers, not terms, powers. 2nc4 a power of n minus 4 b power of 4 and so on. And then this again depends on the value of n. So, we leave this as is for now. Okay. So, can you not write this as 2 into a power of n nc0 and this is nc2 into a power of n minus 2 b square plus nc4 into a power of n minus 4 b power of 4 and so on. So, that means in short, can we not write this as 2 into sum of terms at odd places? Yes. So, when we add a plus b whole power of n plus a minus b whole power of n, we will get 2 into sum of terms at odd places. You might be wondering, here the powers are even, then why are we saying odd here? If you observe the binomial expansion very clearly, this is first place, second place, third place and so on. What did you see? Power 0, even though it's an even number, it's in the first place. Because we're starting from 0, the entire system gets changed. That is, power 0 is at even place, power 0 is at odd place, power 1 is at even place, power 2 is at odd place, etc. That is the reason we are writing sum of terms at odd places here, because the even terms are at odd places. Okay, so in the same way, if you subtract, let's see what happens if we subtract. If we say a plus b whole power of n minus a minus b whole power of n, what we get is alternately subtract. So, this one and this one will get subtracted. So, it gets cancelled. This one is good. This minus will change to plus. So, we'll get 2 into nc1 a power of n minus 1 b plus 2 into nc3 a power of n minus 3 into b cube plus 2 into nc5 a power of n minus 5 into b power of 5 and so on. So, these are nothing but, I told you, right? It's at even places. So, sum of the terms at even places. So, this is what happens when you add and when you subtract two binomial expansions. Okay, having the same variance. Okay, so this is one of the important observations that you need to keep in mind. Now, what if I take this as one of the term as one in the binomial binomial, another one is x. Suppose if I take a as 1 and b as x, how do you write the expansion of this? Nc0 1 power of n x power of 0 plus nc1 1 power of n minus 1 x power of 1 plus nc2 1 power of n minus 2 x square plus and so on plus ncr 1 power of n minus r and x to the power of r plus and so on plus ncn 1 power of n minus n x to the power of n. A simply substituted 1 and x in the place of a and b in the binomial theorem. So what do we get here? We get nc0 into 1, right? Plus nc1 into x plus nc2 into x square into x cube and so on plus ncr into x to the power of r plus and so on plus ncn into x power of n. Right? So, can we not write this as sigma? You must be knowing already, but sigma is the sum of the terms, addition of the terms. Sigma r is equal to 0 because r is this one, so r starts from 0 to n. So, this sigma means it's an expansion where you substitute r starting from 0 to n and then write this. 0 nc r into x to the power of r. Yes. So, 1 plus x whole power of n can be written as this. Okay. In the same way, if we take 1 minus x whole power of n, what will happen is the only thing that will change is this sign, because x will be negative, right? So I'm just changing the signs. You can alternate the signs based on the value of x. Again, we don't know the value of r, so what we take is we'll take minus 1 whole to the power of r. If it's positive, I mean, it's if it's even, it will get positive. If it's odd, it will get negative. And then here also we'll decide. We don't know the value of n now. So we'll just write minus 1 whole to the power of n. Okay. In short, can we not write this as sigma r is equal to 0 to n minus 1 whole to the power of r, because we don't know the value of r, ncr into extra power of r, because one of the term is minus. So this is what happens when you expand minus 1 whole to the power, 1 minus x whole to the power of n. So the expansion of 1 minus x whole to the power of n is this. Okay, so now let's see one example. Let's take 1 minus x whole to the power of 5. I'm just taking an example here. So this can be applicable to any other values of n also. So let's now try to expand 1 minus x whole power of 5 using this. So here x is 5, n is 5, right? And b is minus x. So what we'll do is, first let's write r is equal to 0 to 5, substitute 5 substitute 5 in place of n, then we get 5 cr x power of r. This is the expansion. Now how do you write this? You write this as 1 to the power of 5 and x to the power of minus x to the power of 0 plus 5 c1. Remember what I told you while expanding this, just put minus x in place of b. 1 to the power of 4 into minus x whole to the power of 1 plus 5 c2 into 1 to the power of 3 and minus x whole square plus 5 c3 into 1 to the power of 2, and then we get what? Minus x whole to the power of 3 plus 5c4 into 1 to the power of 1 and minus x whole to the power of 4 plus 5c5 into 1 to the power of 0 minus x whole to the power of 5. How do we write this now? We'll simply write this as 5c0 minus 5c1 into x, right, because it's minus here, plus 5c2 into x square, because r is v2 in the second term, minus 5c3 into x cube, because r is 3 and it will be negative, plus 5c4 into x to power of 4, minus 5c5 into x to power of 5. Right, we are alternating the signs based on the value of r. So what is this? Pascal's triangle coefficients. Sometimes what happens is the coefficients, I mean the value of n will increase, that is 7, 8, 9, 10. In that case, it's not feasible to write Pascal's triangle. So in that case, we directly solve the coefficients using the formula NCR. You know that NCR is equal to n factorial by n minus r whole factorial into r factorial. So we'll put n and r in here and we find out. In this case, 5c0 is 5 factorial by 5 minus 0 whole factorial into 0 factorial, like that. Okay, so 5c0 is 1, 5c1 is 5x, 5c2 is 10x square, 5c3 is also 10, so 10x cube, plus 5x to the power of 4 minus x to the power of 5. So this is the expansion of 1 minus x whole power of 5 using binomial expansion. Okay. So these variables, these coefficients, it's very easy to identify them using the formula of NCR. And I've told you the concept of equidistant. If you see here, right, the coefficient from the right side and coefficient from left side are equal. This is equal to this. This is equal to this. And here we have how many terms? Even terms. Right, because we have six terms here. So the coefficients, the values of the coefficients are same when they are equidistant from one another. And these are nothing but what? That means 5c0 is equal to 5c5. Yes. And 5c1 is equal to 5c4. See here, 1 plus 4 is 5. Ultimately, the result is 5. And 5c2 is equal to 5c3. Okay. So this is how you expand using binomial theorem. Okay. So, what is the rth term or the general term in binomial expansion? This is a very frequently asked question in MCET, AIEEE or IIT for that matter. This is extremely important for you to understand what exactly it means. So the rth term means, suppose we want to find the 10th term in the binomial expansion, 12th term of the binomial expansion, 15th term of the 100th term of the binomial expansion. It is not feasible for us to write, if I say I want to find 2x plus 3y whole power of 30 and want to find the 15th term here. Do you think every time you want to write such a big expansion and then find a particular term? No, it's time waste for you, right? In order to get the general term, that is why we always put in our expansion something about R. If you remember, we say that as NCR into A to the power of N minus R, B power of R. This R can be the general term. That means, so this is the expansion of A plus B whole power of N, right? So I want to identify, say, 20th term in this expansion. I assume N is 30. So it will be what? A plus B whole power of 30, right? So for me to identify the 20th term, right, what does it mean? It means I have to take 0, 1, 2 and so on up to how many? 19, not 20. Because here I have just written values. Assume these are 20 terms in binomial expansion. You start from 0, count from 0. This is 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 0 to 10, we have 11 terms. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That means the 20th term in the binomial expansion is in fact the 19th term in the expansion. Yes, that is the reason we represent the general term as tr plus 1. Because it is starting from 0, the power is starting from 0. So in order to find the 20th term in this expansion, you need to actually find the 19th term. That means you need to put r as 19 here. So we'll get how much r is 19. So in short, you need to find t19 plus 1 and put r as 19 in this and you'll get the general term. That means tr plus 1 is equal to ncr. Again, let's assume that there is, sometimes we get negative, right? So tr plus 1 is equal to minus 1 whole to the power of r, ncr, a power of n minus r, b power of r, and this is the general term for the expansion, in the expansion a plus b whole power of n. So the general term in the expansion a plus b whole power of n is this, okay, tr plus 1. Now let's see a quick problem. Here, this is an example problem for you. We need to find the 28th term of 5x plus 8y whole power of 30. So we know that the general term formula is, because plus, we don't have to consider minus 1 whole power of r, ncr, a to the power of n minus r, b to the power of r, right? We need to find 28th term. That means technically, is it the 27th term? Yes. So if you consider r plus 1 as 28, you get r value is 27, because 28 minus 1 is 27. So in short, t28 can be written as t27 plus 1, which is nothing but, what is n here? 30. So 30c27, because we need to put r, not r plus 1 value here. 27, 5x whole to the power of 30 minus 27 and 8y whole to the power of 27. So that is nothing but 30c27, 5x whole cube into 8y to the power of 27. So this is the general term or 28th term of the expansion